Good morning, good afternoon, and good evening. Here we are. We are at our final assignment, and I'm very excited to see what y'all come up with. So, first and foremost, please make sure that you reach out to your partner, let them know you are alive and well and ready to go. Or even if you're not ready to go, you're still willing, okay? All right, so that being the case, once you've reached out to your partner and let them know, hey, I'm alive, I'm here, I want you to decide on a topic. Okay, so this is going to be a little bit different than what you're probably used to in any other classes where you've done debates or argument papers, because we are going to do something very similar to our television analysis paper. Recall in the paper that we didn't go through and decide, you know, say, oh, this TV show was just a good episode. Like, we didn't critique the episode. We critiqued the characters and their behaviors and their actions. Okay, remember that? So we are going to be doing the same thing in a film or a TV show. You get to choose. You get to choose three different options with your partner. Maybe it's two TV shows and one film, or one film and two, you know, or two films and one TV show. You get to decide. The biggest thing that you need to consider is that you are going to look at the choices that the characters are making, their behaviors, what are they doing, and you get to argue over that. Does that make sense? So again, we're not arguing about the show and whether or not the TV show or the film was good or bad. Your ultimate goal here is to utilize everything that you have learned in this class and apply it to what you're seeing in the film based on characters' actions, or, you know, lack of action, I guess you might say. So think about every time that we watched a film, how you had to go through and you're answering some questions and you were utilizing the vocabulary words and the things that we learned in class to what the characters were doing in the film. I never said, hey, do you like this film? There was never those questions. It was always, what is this person doing in regards to maybe a moral or ethical issue? What kind of fallacies might they have been using? What kind of inductive or deductive reasoning did these characters have? So think about that when you're thinking of a film, or if you're thinking about a TV show. Think about how, think, that's what we do here in class. We think a lot. Consider what they're doing and try and find ways that you might be able to argue one side and your partner can argue another. So the idea here is, for example, you want to decide with the characters, what are their choices? Were they, you know, did they have moral or ethical issues? Were there reality assumptions that the characters had in their head, which is why they made the choices that they made? Did they use faulty deductive or inductive reasoning? And again, you'll have to go back and research your vocabulary words if you can't remember how these are applied. Did they use manipulative language? Remember, we talk about spin and all these other different ways in which characters would use these particular things to, you know, get their point across for themselves. And remember, we talked about most recently in chapter 9, ethnocentric, right? Or egocentric behavior. Ethno is, oh, my religion and my, you know, culture is better than someone else's, or egocentric, where I am better than all people and nothing I ever do is wrong, right? So these are things that you can also use, because we're going to be up to chapter 9 for this debate assignment. Okay, so you can also argue about the message of the film. That's okay too, because the characters are going to help push forward the main point of the movie or the TV show. And because of that, you might have an ultimate theme. So I'm trying to think of an example of a theme. I guess in Thank You for Smoking, you know, the question would be ultimately, is smoking bad for you? Or is it okay that we have the choice? Or is it because it's out there and we have so much manipulation, is that a bad thing too, right? So there's so many different ways you can argue it. It's up to you to decide how you want to argue it, okay? Keep in mind that you will already have a winner in the end of this without actually debating. So normally in class, we would have someone stand up and there would be kind of like a fake debate. But here you're going to be doing a PowerPoint with kind of like a fake debate where you will know ultimately who the winner is based on all the research and everything that you've done. So I'm going to get to that in just a second. The main point here is to find a film or a TV show where there's characters who are literally following. Think about fallacious arguments, Again, types of behaviors, maybe something that's manipulative. Like, what is this character doing? And do you agree or disagree? It's kind of what we're looking at here. Let's see here. You might also, you can also debate that, say there's something within it that's stereotypical and you argue against it and why it should be taken off. Like, you can do things, you know, taken off the air or no longer shown. Like, you can kind of argue that too. But the biggest thing I want you to really focus on is a TV show or a film that's going to embrace as much of what we've talked about as possible. So consider that. So you may not argue about a film you've written about in class or one that has been shown in class. Okay. So keep that in mind. We want originality, something fun and new that I'm going to be excited to watch again. Okay. All right. So the final debate is actually going to be PowerPoints, or you can do a film. You can actually do a film. That's fine too. If you happen to have a time where you can sit down with your partner and together film it, or I don't know, piece something together. I've seen students do some incredibly creative things, so I don't want to step on toes. You do what you got to do. But if you just want to do a PowerPoint, again, you each have to turn in a PowerPoint. If you do a video, you each have to turn in a video. These are going to be due May 27th. There is no, I am not going to change that date. There's no extension. It is due when it is due. So keep that in mind. All right. So I'm going to go through really quick, step by step, the things that you're going to need to do to be successful in this. Okay. So make sure you're paying attention. You're watching this all the way through and you're also taking a look online. So step number one, you're going to need to formulate a point of your argument. So you got to figure out, what are we going to argue? Okay. Once you've decided on a topic, first and foremost, you're going to decide on what you want to do. Again, you have three different, you get to turn in three different choices and kind of, I think we're going to do this. And then I can say, any of those will do, as I usually do. Majority of you are pretty much on it. I might argue a little bit and go, are you sure that's what you want to do? And help you to rethink it. But for the most part, I have, you know, usually things are good, but do give me three options that I can take a look at, and then we can kind of hone into something that's going to be the best. Include links, include information that I'm going to be able to go through and be like, oh yeah, that's great. So when you turn in your topic assignment, make sure that you're letting me know exactly what the topic is, what you want to argue against or for. Okay. All right. So once you've come up with that, I want you to throw something in like, when you remember the Dallas Buyers Club and remember how Ron in the very beginning, you're like, this guy is just the biggest creep. Like, I hate this guy. I don't want to like him at all. And then towards the end, he redeems himself and he's changed his behaviors from being homophobic to actually helping out the community to the best of his abilities, you know, for being a drug dealer. Okay. All right. And then someone will argue that it's false. He didn't change in the end. He only changed for selfish reasons, right? So you can, don't use that film, but that's a way you can argue a main topic. Okay. All right. Step number two, I want you to find at least two supportive outside sources each. So you pick two, your partner picks two. Okay. And these are going to be sources. No Wikipedia, no Wikipedia. Hey, Wikipedia. I've opened it up and I opened up a can of worms. Don't do Wikipedia. It doesn't do anything. Okay. I would like you to find sources that are going to back up your main point. Okay. So, let's think of some, like an argument might be, it's like above when we had, Ron, originally he was a huge homophobic. And that was kind of a big issue for the film because he didn't believe in, you know, the fact that he had AIDS because he was like, well, I can't be gay. And he's freaking out over it, right? But when you look back and research, one of your main sources is going to look back at the percentage of people who were homophobic or were misinformed about AIDS or however it is. You want to find really deep research. Okay. And scholarly journals are usually my favorite. I'd love to see data. That's kind of my go-to. You can go to the Butte Library for that. Those are the things I prefer to find, not just someone's opinion on a blog post because this is what they thought. Okay. So we as researchers and critical thinkers, we know how to delve deep and find real, true research, not just something that we Googled really quick. And we're like, oh, I don't know. That's the answer. I don't want that. That's why I hate, that's why I hate Wikipedia. Cause I feel like that's the first thing that pops up. It's the first thing people use. And to be honest, Wikipedia is not really all that great. And majority of the time, if you check the sources that were below, you're like, that link didn't go anywhere. And it had no reflection to what they were talking about above at all. They just required it, so they put it in there. See why I don't like Wikipedia? So, anywho, if you went to Wikipedia and went to another article that took you somewhere that had some legitimate data, that's okay too. You can do that, but don't use Wikipedia. I'm going to argue that. Okay, so you want to use, when you use these outside sources, as per usual, use a signal phrase. I know you're doing a PowerPoint, but introduce the quote, introduce the information. Let us know where is this coming from, okay? So it's not just out of the blue. If I see statistics or data or information that has no source whatsoever, that's not good. All right, so don't fail this final assignment. That's the last thing you want to do because you don't have a chance to redeem yourself. So please make sure, you've got your partner, you have sources online, you've got the library, you got CAS, C-A-S, go check them out if you have any questions on how to cite sources, okay? So keep that in mind as you move forward that I will be looking for that. Okay, step number three, I want you to use a clip of the film that illustrates the defining moments that you discuss when you're in your arguments, right? So don't put the whole film and be like, it's in there somewhere. Find a little clip, 3 minutes max. I don't want to sit there and have to click through and go, where the hell is this? Okay, so again, you can check with your partner, you can go to tech support and ask them, how do I do this? Like, this is where you start utilizing your critical thinking skills. How and where are you going to find the information and how are you going to do it? Okay, so I can only tell you so much, but in the end, it ultimately comes to you to be the one to go, all right, I can do this. I can figure this out on my own to the best of my abilities. Okay, reach out for help. There's only so much that I can do. Go to the source or go to the experts. And usually that's the library because they have all the resources you could possibly find. Okay, so make sure that you caption your clips that you use with a source so I know where it came from. A lot of y'all did it really, really well in your PowerPoints. I didn't necessarily mark you down if you did it wrong on the PowerPoints for your advertisement, just as a heads up. So please be mindful of that. Okay, so again, on your PowerPoint, I want everything to be queued up where it needs to be. So when I get to that, it goes straight to it and I go, there we are. All right, because it takes a lot to go through these, and I don't want to have to go clicking through to try and find where I need to go. All right, step number four, you and your teammate will choose 10 vocabulary words. All right, remember, vocabulary is key. There's a reason why I am so vocabulary heavy in this class, because when you start to understand the definitions and how to use it, you really do make stronger, more valid points to what you're trying to say. Okay, so make sure you go to Dietzler. Consider how you're going to use these that really emphasize the main point. Don't just go, I know that definition. I know that definition. I know that one. So I'm just going to put those in there. Don't do that to yourself. Utilize the vocabulary that's actually going to make your point and make your point stronger. Okay, use at least 3 from chapter 9. Okay, chapter 9, remember, it's got the fair-mindedness, egocentric, ethnocentric, like all these different terms that I spent a lot of time going over in that very long lecture. So please utilize this. It's very important. All right. The rest of the words should come from at least 4 other chapters. Okay. So we've got 5, remember, we've got 10 total vocabulary words and 3 of them. 3 of them are going to be from one chapter. The rest need to be from 4 others. I don't know what my hand was doing there. I was trying to do math. It didn't really work. I'm an English major. Anywho, so in other words, 4 different chapters, all right, spread all over. I don't want vocabulary words all from one chapter. Spread the love. Show me that you've got something from this. And if your partner and you can't figure this out, That worries me a little bit, but message me if you're stuck. But again, 10 vocabulary words from at least 5 different chapters. Okay. All right. So again, you got to use vocabulary correctly and in context. When I went through your vocabulary words assignments, I made notes and I'm all, that's not used right. That's not used right. And I took points away. So I'm going to be a little bit tougher on this grading. It's your final assignment. I've given you a lot of feedback to the best of my abilities. If you're not reading your feedback, I don't know what to tell you. So please make sure that you and your partner pay attention to this, that you're using the words correctly and within the context. So they have to make sense. You're not just throwing vocabulary words in there and going, Here you go. I've caught you a few times doing that, some of you, and I made a note. This does not apply. This does not work. Why are you using this here? So just keep that in mind. So be mindful of the words. Otherwise, you're just kind of throwing stuff out there. And again, for someone who's a critical thinker, you know, when they're listening to you talk, they'll be like, what are they saying? Why did they throw that word in there? So, right? So anyway, and plus it's great practice, absolute great practice that you can use in the future. Okay, so step number 5, I want you to prepare a summary of the film's plot, okay? And I want an overview of the pertinent characters, the most important characters that you're using, and at least one sentence of background information. And again, you did this before in your TV show analysis. I just need to know when it came out, who directed it, and who started it. Okay, super simple sentence there. But do have a summary of the plot, an overview of the main characters, and at least one sentence of a background. The biggest thing is I don't want you to spend all this time going on and on and on about this show, because in the end, I'm like, I don't care about the show. I care about the characters. What are they doing? Tell me more about what the characters are doing. Okay. Make sure that you cite IMDb, because that's where you're going to be getting the quote. Most people just go through IMDb because those are direct quotes and it's validated. Okay, so if your summary uses words borrowed from a source, hint, hint, if you're using exact words, you got to identify the source, use a signal phrase, and quote it. Remember, parenthetical citations. It's where you put the last name of the author in the parentheses. If you don't have an author, you just put the title of the work. And then at the end of that, you put a period. This might be backwards, but you put a period at the very end of the parentheses. Okay, here we go. The debate itself, first, again, you have to turn in your topic idea. And then that's going to be the first part. And then a list of the 10 vocabulary terms in a bibliography. That's the next thing to do. Check online for the exact dates that I want these. Okay. All right. Each of you will have an even amount of slides that will argue the main point with sources. Okay. So however long it is, there's no max. There is a minimum, obviously. You can't just do 4 slides. You're going to have to do more. Okay. 4 slides would be, you each only have 2 slides. That's ridiculous. So you got to do some work here and I'm going to be looking for it. Okay. So each of you will have an even amount, and that for each one of those, you're going to have sources that validate your argument. Okay, you're going to validate your argument with the sources, whether it's the vocabulary, whether it's the book, whether it's those outside sources. You're going to have to show me where you got your information. Okay, next we have the winning side. So the winning side is the side that you choose is going to win. Whether you both say, all right, I agree that, you know, the character in the end, you know, really was a morally corrupt person despite their change throughout time, right? That could be, you both agree to that. And so that would be the winning argument. So the winning argument is going to be the last slide. Okay. The final slide that's going to close the whole debate. Okay. That final slide, aside from your works cited, there's always a works cited page. Before the works cited page, this second to last page is going to include the final argument, the main point, how you got there. Okay. All right, so each of you should appear to be doing your best to win, right? So even though you already know who's going to be the winner, I want both sides to really show I'm arguing hard. Even though originally we know who's going to win, I'm going to show you that I probably should have won because I worked really hard on my sources and validating my main points. Okay, so think about that. Again, solid sources, solid points. I really need you to show me that you're trying to make a point here. Even if you're not the winning point, I still want you to try hard as if you were actually in a true debate. By the way, lawyers do this all the time. So if you're really good at it, you could be a lawyer and make a lot of money. Okay. All right. So each argument needs to be supported by your sources. All right. You got to use your sources to validate your main point and make sure you include quoted dialogue. All right. You got to quote main exact wordings and a description of any of the characters' actions that are pertinent to the argument. Okay. So any descriptions, anything that you're using, I want you to validate that. So if there's a part in a TV show or a movie, I noticed a lot of you will use a timestamp, and that's beautiful. Go ahead and use that. So it's something we can always go back to. Let's see here. All right. Each debater is responsible for 5 of your 10 vocabulary words. So one of you isn't like, well, let's just use these 10. You both need to come up with at least 5, right? So 5 different vocabulary terms for each of you. Total of 10. Okay. Be wise in what you assume is your audience. Okay. So, how much knowledge or ignorance might your audience have? So when you're making an argument, make an argument that really proves that point. So just, you kind of assume a little bit of ignorance, but also a little bit of knowledge too. Okay. So know who your audience is. You may create notes for your debate in a bulleted or outline form. So if you want, and you want to turn in a piece of paper as if you were to argue it, you can do bullet points. You could do that on your PowerPoint slide. Just something that shows me, an outline of how each debate would be. So majority of students do their first argument on one slide, and they can make a couple points here and there and with their sources. And the next person would do the same in argument to those bulleted points. You could do it however you want, but just to show me this is your argument and then this is argument to that argument, right? It's a debate. This is how debates go. However you feel you need to do that so that it is clear and understood by anybody who's reading it, okay? All right. So that's if you're doing a PowerPoint. You can do a PowerPoint, or you can also do a scripted debate that is recorded. You can absolutely do that. Those are always fun too. If you do that, you might still need to include, not might, you're going to still need to include the sources where you get your information so that I can see it. So it's not just you and a friend sitting back and forth having a conversation. It needs to be a legitimate and true debate. I need to have that piece of paper with the bulleted arguments, with your vocabulary words, and with your sources. So you're still going to have to turn in something with the video to show me that you know exactly what you're talking about, okay? So if for some reason you are filming it, again, do note that it is actually scripted, so you're going to show that you have been practicing, and it's not just a willy-nilly back and forth goofy thing at all. Okay, so both of you will deliver the debate as if you don't know in advance to your partner what your partner's going to say. But obviously you will know. You'll decide together which of your arguments is more persuasive, and then that person will speak last. Okay, so again, very much like the PowerPoint, but it would be like as if you were truly debating. The debate should open very strongly, and the first speaker is introducing the film and then laying out the position of what the argument is. And then each of your arguments should close strongly. Again, even though you guys are knowing who's going to be the winner, I want you both to have a very strong ending and go, and that's my point. Okay, and with a clear stance at the final statement. So we need to know exactly where you stand and why, based on what reasoning. Okay, all right, so you should address the fallacies made by your partner. So obviously you know that because you'll be working together. But if you have your partner make a fallacious argument, you will step back and go, hey, this is where you were fallacious in your argument. That's a straw man argument, or so forth. Okay. So again, you want to name the fallacy that the partner is making, and then you want to refute it. Okay. So the entire debate will last about 5 minutes. So if you're recording it, 5 minutes, all right, don't go on and on for hours, but don't cut it real short. 5 minutes. It's called practice. Okay. All right. The grading criteria, this is very important. So when I'm going through and I'm grading, these are the things that I'm looking for. And I do this with all my assignments. And some of you are like, why do you keep marking me down? I'm like, I told you, I need you to respond to your peers or whatever it was that didn't get done. All right, so the grading criteria, put a check mark next to this, print it, however you need to get this complete. This is what I'm gonna be looking for. So I need your topic turned in on time, okay? When you turn that in, then we go, done. Vocabulary list turned in on time. Same thing. 10 vocabulary words. 3 from chapter 9. The rest from 5 other chapters. Okay. Well-supported argument about an approved film. Remember, you have to turn that in so I can approve it. If you don't turn it in and I can't approve it, how are you going to pass this assignment? Okay. So make sure the film is approved and the argument is handled with depth and critical thinking. Okay, I'm really going to be looking for this as the practice. I really want to be able to see that you utilized everything we've covered in this class and made your final point. Okay, so the use of at least 2 fallacies one each. Each one of you will choose a fallacy that you're going to be using, and which are then called out and rebuted. So whoever is using the fallacy, you know, here's Joe Schmo. Joe Schmo makes a fallacious argument, and then Peter Rabbit over here argues it. Okay. And then Peter Rabbit makes an argument and Joe Schmo argues it. Okay. See how that works? So you each have at least one fallacious, like a fallacy, right? Whether it's a straw man or a red herring or any of these that we use, one of you will be making it and the other will rebut it. They'll call you out and then they're going to rebut it. Okay. All right. So, make sure you have a clear explanation and a summary of the film. Short, sweet, to the point. I don't need a bunch of stuff. I don't care about what they're wearing. I don't need a bunch of other things. I just need to know a clear and straight to the point. Like, what is this film? What is it about? What's the main point? Okay. Quick summary. All right. I do need a use of the film. So 3 minutes, just a little clip. Again, if you can't figure this out, you can either message the whole class and say, hey, guys, how are you doing this? You could reach out to the library. You can reach out to tech through the library as well. There's a lot of different ways if you cannot figure that out. So just keep that in mind. Okay, I want you to use the film dialogue. There is going to be dialogue, especially ones that you can apply and go, this is a fallacious argument where he said this and this was, you know, egocentric behavior, ethnocentric dialogue or something along those lines. Utilize the film's dialogue. Okay. Individual contribution to research and planning of arguments. Okay. So that means both of you are going to be contributing your own information. It's not one person just putting it together and going, hey, you want to sign your name to it. Nobody likes that type of thing. Nobody likes to be the partner who's not doing anything, right? So make sure that you are both contributing evenly and equally when planning this argument, okay? If you're having problems with your partner and they're not getting back to you or something weird's going on, message me. I hate to offer you to do it on your own. That's not good. It's going to be a lot of work. So please try and work with your partner. But if for some reason they're not getting back to you and things are getting weird, just let me know. I don't have actually really any of these kind of issues with this class. So I'd be very, very surprised if that was the case. So yeah, just let me know. But I'm sure y'all are going to be fine. Let's see here. Preparedness on the due date of the debate. So we're not turning in things late because once this closes, it's done. There's no late assignments due. No excuses. I know a lot of you are going to be like, but this happened and this happened. Darlings, this is like the beginning of May that we are doing this, as it is due the end of May. So be prepared and work as hard as you can to get it done sooner than later. Okay. So, and the reason why I do that is there has to be a deadline because they have deadlines for me as a teacher to turn in grades and consensus and all that stuff. So anywhoosies, so make sure that you are very prepared for the debate, okay? Let's see, organization of the debate. So make sure it's organized, really well done, you know, argument, and then a rebuttal and back and forth. And make sure that you have a very strong opening for both sides and then a very strong closing for both sides. Make sure you utilize those non-film sources, okay? Those outside sources that are going to validate your points with research. And I'm talking legitimate research, like the data. You want the data. That's how you're going to win an argument have a very strong argument is data. Not opinion, not what you think, what you feel. I don't care about how you think. I don't care about how you feel. No offense. I want the research and I want you to back it up. Okay. All right. And that's how it should be. Whenever you hear things about a thing, you should always be like, where's the data? Where's the research? Show me the data. Okay. I'm getting weird. It's getting far into this lecture, y'all. Okay. So, organization of the debate. Let's see. So avoid reading or a prepared script if you're doing a recording. I would like it to try and sound a little bit more spontaneous, you know, but prepared, okay? Not farting around, but prepared, okay? So just keep that in mind. So practice. Okay, use signal phrases to credit your sources as per usual. Let's see here. Establish authority, where'd the information come from, if it's from your Nana, unless she's got a couple degrees and research papers on it, you're going to want to try and really solidify who your source is, whether it's a doctor of a particular thing, however it is. So why is that person worth listening to? So if you're going to, you know, give authority you know, which is funny because appeal to authority is actually a fallacy, right? But anyway, you can use a particular authority to let us know, like, their voice is the reason, you know, we listen to them because of blah, blah, right? Their voice is important because they are such and such of such and such. Okay? All right. So you can actually use Dietzler. You don't have to explain Dietzler's history. I know who she is. I know she wrote a book. You could say doctor of blah, blah, or however. You can make a mention of, you know, Dietzler, the author of blah, blah. And that is enough. You don't have to do more than that. You don't have to give me her whole life story. Just say, you know, Dietzler, the author of blah, blah. So include her first name, obviously. Make sure you include her at least once. Make sure you give her authority. And make sure you include IMDb at least once. You will, because you're going to be using that information, whether it's the summary of the, well, you're not going to be using IMDb as a summary, but for the quotes, because you're going to be using dialogue quotes. Okay, so I used IMDb at least once. And you will be using it to explain who the producer, when it was filmed, and all that good stuff. Okay, all right. Last but definitely not least for the final debate is the execution. All right, how are you going to execute and show me all the information that you have gathered together to make this a successful final project? I want you to use appropriate diction, familiarity with the subject. When I say poise and volume and stuff like that, and appearance, again, that's if it's recorded. But the biggest thing is a well thought out and created PowerPoint, not just a bunch of stuff you just stuffed together and said, here, take it. Stuff that you show me, like when I go through, I'm like, ooh, I want to be able at the very end to be like, I don't know who won. Like, you both did such a good job in arguing your main points. Like, I don't even know how to say who won this debate. That's the ultimate goal, for you to both feel so confident and work so hard that in the end, we're both like, man, that was good. That was good. I probably would have picked either side. And that's what we ultimately want to go for. Okay. So just make sure you utilize the video or the PowerPoint to the best of your abilities to make your main point and argue your point. And just, all right, show me what your film is and how you agree or disagree with the characters or the main point of said film. So, all right, that was it. Hopefully this wasn't too painful to watch. And if not, if you have any questions, let me know. And it's been a pleasure. I'm excited to see what you come up with.